Ely is Cardiff's largest council estate. It was built after the World Wars, so the returning soldiers had somewhere to live. This is where 80s pop star Shaken Stevens grew up. And other than that, there's not really much to say about the place. Overlooking the estate, beyond those trees, is a bit of a secret. A place that has been constantly vandalised and reborn for nearly 1,000 years. There's a couple of clues in the nearby street names to what lies beyond those trees. Up an almost impossibly steep slope is an ancient hill fort, one of the oldest areas of settlement in South Wales, established about 2,000 years ago. That's all very interesting, but there's something else on that unassuming piece of grass which caught my eye. Just out of sight, and poking out the grass like a curious mole, is the medieval church of St Mary's. A fragile ruin with a really interesting story. Not the first church to be built on this site, but this particular structure was built between 1254 and 1291. It was the Church of Cardiff before Llandaff Cathedral was built. Vandalism seems to be a key theme of its history, with the first recorded account in 1547. Protestants destroyed the interior of churches, including this one. This was in an attempt to destroy luxury and grandeur, as they didn't really agree with that. In 1648, during the nearby Battle of St Fagans, some of Cromwell's soldiers, the Roundheads, hid in and around the church during the battle. The church was closed in 1957 after nearly a century of being active, when St Timothy's down the road was opened. During the years that followed its closure, there was large-scale vandalism, and it was decided to turn St Mary's into a ruin. The roof was removed and doors and windows were bricked up. Thieves stole the ancient bronze bell from the tower by knocking a hole in the east side of it. This has never been recovered. So if there's been this huge honking great big bell stuck in the corner of your garden shed for a couple of years, this is probably where it's come from. A few years later, two men set about to restore the church, one of those being Father Victor Jones. A group of men from St Timothy's, the sister church of St Mary's, set about the task. Reverend Jones camped on the site during the reconstruction of the church to make sure that nobody vandalised the ongoing work or any materials were stolen from the site. It became a real community project. After April 1961, there were regular church services, including weddings and baptisms, all the usual church stuff. A few years later, Reverend Jones left the parish to become a padre with the Royal Navy. In 1973, the church was closed and deconsecrated. Continuous vandalism and theft of many of the original features, the church once again deteriorated into ruins. The site is now owned by Cardiff Council, but it's actually a group of volunteers called the Friends of St Mary's that really look after the place. They work tirelessly to maintain the site, removing litter and dealing with the mindless vandalism which still happens a lot today. And it's definitely worth noting that if you come here or somewhere like it, you leave it as you found it. Thanks, Bert. After an absence of 50 years, Reverend Jones returned to the church to a hero's welcome. Reverend Jones was visibly emotional to be back in his old parish, where he said his heart still remains, and spoke about his desire for his ashes to be scattered there after his death. Who knows? There may be another life in this church yet. Damn it, I split a hole in my trousers.